In other news here this morning, the Lewis and Clark Caverns, Montana's first state park. It's also one of the more popular parks.
Yeah, and this week in Fish and Wildlife, we return to the caverns, where a winter's worth of renovations are just a few days away from being available for everyone to see.
This week in Fish and Wildlife, sponsored by your local Montana Toyota dealers.
Thursday morning time once again for This Week in Fish and Wildlife. We are in Lewis and Clark Caverns getting ready for opening here. Tom Forwood joining us again this morning. Wow, it's almost summer. It may not feel like it outside, but summer season at Lewis and Clark Caverns kicking off here pretty soon.
Yeah, it is coming in quick. And for us, school season is the big thing right around the corner. We open May 1st, and most of May, we've got school kids here almost every day during the week. So it's, even though general tourist season in Montana hasn't started, it's a big time for us. We're really excited to get the place open.
Let's just talk about what folks have the ability to do here, because I know you've expanded some tour opportunities in that. Sure. You have the general tour. You have opportunities for folks that maybe have a little difficulty getting in. Let's just talk about some of those options for people to see what Lewis and Clark Caverns has to offer.
Absolutely. I mean, traditionally we offered a cave tour, and then the winter, back since the 90s, we've been doing those candlelight tours. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, we had to take those off this year while construction went, but we're going to continue those again in the future. And then for the summer season, we've added two more tour types to kind of expand the range of abilities, basically, for doing a cave tour. We've gone with a more adventurous one. We have the wild cave tours now, which happen twice a week from mid-June through mid-August. Those are by reservation only. You have to call us and get advanced set up to do a wild cave tour. And those are Sunday and Tuesday nights. Now, every day we're going to be offering both our Paradise Tour and our Classic Tour. The Classic Tour is how we've labeled the one we've always done. So the Classic Cave Tour will continue every day throughout the day. And that's a pretty rigorous tour. It's actually one of the harder tours I've ever been on. That's like a non-helmet, you know, just walk through a cave. Mm-hmm. So that has always been limiting for some folks. We've had people try to push themselves and maybe get in trouble or something doing that. So we've really expanded upon our Paradise Tour, which goes in the bottom, the biggest rooms in the cave, and gives people an opportunity to come check that out without taxing themselves too much if, you know, they're not up for a real rigorous hike for the day. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it's great for people with small children, maybe people with disabilities and whatnot. There's like a lot of opportunities for people that traditionally may have had trouble going to see the cave. That's going to be something we're still offering every day now. And we've kind of done that program the last 2 years. It's been a big success. We've like double visitation on those tours the last 2 years. So,
and make no mistake, you're not going to see everything in the cave, but you will see every feature that is in Lewis and Clark Caverns.
Exactly. You're going to see all the key types of features, all the major things that we feature through the regular tour are in those big rooms at the end. And you're seeing the biggest room in the entire cave and the biggest formations. Mm-hmm. And you get to spend a lot more time there than a regular tour does. Mm-hmm. So there's trade-offs, but, you know, like I said, the regular tour is pretty rigorous. The Classic Tour probably isn't going to fit for every single box. Mm-hmm. For every person out there, but it's a great opportunity to get to see and enjoy Lewis and Clark Caverns and get a lot of the same information and enjoy the beauty of this place.
You folks ready? I know it's been a busy winter working on the hand railings and the lighting project and all of that. It's been a little different off season than you usually have, but as May 1st gets ever closer, you folks ready to have school kids and all the rest of us come through?
Absolutely. Once we get open and we get all those school kids, we get everybody coming, they're going to have a great cave experience, because a really wet year means the cave is really wet coming into the spring off of that heavy snow winter. So we're going to have a lot of dripping and activity in here. So bring your not nicest clothes, maybe, if you're coming out to see the cave this year. This is going to be a very different experience for almost anybody that's been here before. Every time I walk through right now, I'm like, wow, this just has a different feel to it. So it's kind of a great opportunity for people to see the cave again, but for the first time.
That's perfect, Tom. Thank you for joining us this morning. And that's This Week in Fish and Wildlife.
This Week in Fish and Wildlife was sponsored by Toyota. Let's go places.